Shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all honor and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahawashai, Bahashem, Kakurash. Double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, and peace and salutations unto the elect of the nation of Israel, and to speakable Israelites that scattered abroad, that look like the heathen nations, that starting off with the 144,000, which will be all men, the ruling, governing body in the kingdom of heaven. Then you have the rest of the elect, which will be outside of the 144,000, which will consist of men as well, women and children, that will be saved on the side. 2/3 of our people will be destroyed, that will come back in the kingdom. I also want to say the Israelites, who you call today, so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American, Puerto Rican, Dominican, Jamaican, Haitian, Guatemalans, the Panamanians, those are the Israelites, always have been, always will be. This is your brother Jeremiah, coming back at y'all with another video from End Time Headlines. As y'all can see, it's about Elon Musk again. But this one, we know what their big plans are. To advance transhumanism, this devil, he has a lot of plans up his sleeve. But the Lord is going to allow them to get to a certain point. But then the Lord is going to step in. I want to get that scripture. It's in Thessalonians, I believe it's 2 Thessalonians 2 and 7. Let me see. Yep, it says, "For the mystery of iniquity doeth already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way." You see that? So, and that's Yahweh Shema Osha, the Lord's going to allow him to keep doing certain things as far as this transhumanism stuff and all these different plans he got until it's time for him to go down. And that's when our Lord returns. So this man ain't going to stop. There's going to be many more things that come to pass. But the big one is, the video that I did last time is that MOTB. We're real close to that happening. We're real close. This man thinks he got another 10 years. We don't got that much longer, The scriptures say, he shall speed up the days for the elect's sakes. It says in the book of Matthew 24. I can say for sure that these days are speeding by fast. you wake up, you throw your prayers up, do your lesson, or go to the plantation. Next thing you know, it's 3 or 4 days later. You're back at camp again, Of course, we love going to camp, but, I'm just saying as far as like how the time be flying, man, you lose track of time, But you always got to make sure, you put in this truth first, man. Because any day now, this devil could, go full force with this, this MOTB, make it mandatory, So we got to make sure we're not too focused on things in this world. The scriptures say we use the world and not abuse it. But, we got to make sure we're keeping our eyes single, right? Scriptures also tell you this in 2 Timothy, I believe it's, 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3. The scriptures say, "Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahushua Mashiach." Verse 4, "No man that warreth and entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier." You see that? So, if you too caught up in this, in this system, Esau's world, and things that are coming up in this world, you ain't gonna be paying attention to prophecy. Next thing you know, you're gonna be ass out, just like everybody else in this world. You don't want to be a part of that, man. The scriptures say we're supposed to be children of the day, man. We ain't supposed to be of the night, man. Of this world, we're supposed to be the children of the light. So that's why you gotta constantly watch. This man, it says this in the book of, was in the book of Isaiah 14. Let me get that scripture. Isaiah 14. And it reads, this man, this is this man's mindset, man. You know, this is Isaiah 14, verse 13. It says, for thou hast said in thine heart, meaning in the minds, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of Yahweh, and I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the size of North America. You see, this devil lied to people about landing on the moon, you know, ascending into heaven. You know, we know that he didn't really do that. You know, this man, you know, hey, he said this in verse 14. He says, I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. But verse 15, it says, yet thou shalt be brought down to hell. It says the size of the pit. Now, hell is talking about a condition, you know, a low level, you know, the grave. This man gonna be brought to nothing, you know. It says in the book of, Job, would it say, though his excellency burn up to the heavens, you know, this world, you know, the society that we live in, all this technology that he got, you know, it seems like he got everything, you know, but it ain't gonna be like that forever. It wasn't meant for him to be like on top forever. This man gave him a specific time period to have all these different things, but then, you know, the Lord's gonna take him out. This is verse 4. It says, a verse of chapter 20 of Job. It says, knowest thou not, this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of a hypocrite but for a moment? It says, though his excellency mount up to the heavens, and his head reach into the clouds, yet shall he perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? You see, it's going to be like this man never existed. He never had all this. You know, so he can do all this now, you know, he's gonna damn near see hip everybody. But when the Lord, you know, finally, intervenes, you know, which he will do, but it has to get to a certain point to where he's actually putting this technology in people, you know, and society is, you know, it ain't up and running, you know, this society's still up and running, it's still functioning, we ain't in Jacob's trouble yet, but we're really close, you know, you know, so, you know, we can let this man think whatever he want to think, man, you know. And he's going to also come with that persecution. I was thinking about that, too, in Revelation 12 and verse 12, right? It says, therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. And one says, woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil, when he, you know, it's talking about Esau, Edom, has come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he had but a short time. You see that? And this man knows that the majority of people, he knows that people ain't with this. So what is his plans to do to people that ain't going to be willing to convert or comply? He's going to put them to death. You know, that's in the scriptures. The scriptures say he's going to behead. The scriptures talks about those that are beheaded for not taking the MOTB. You know, I ain't going to go to it, but it's in Revelations, you know. This man, hey, you know, it's going to come to a point where we're going to be tested at our temptation, you know. Either going to, hey, get down or lay down, you know. But we're not to fear, you know. I thought about this scripture right before I did this lesson in Psalms. I think it's Psalms 37 and 7, right? Yep, it says, and rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Right, and that's what we're doing, man. We're not going ahead and trying to tear down what this man got physically and carnally, going up in his buildings or trying to protest or mark. We're not doing none of that. We're waiting for the Lord to have his prophecies come to pass. Because really, the Lord set this man up to do what he's going to do. Right? It says, and fret not thyself, meaning don't worry not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way. He's prospering in his way. He's getting to do a lot of things that he wants to do. It says, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. And this is a wicked device, you know, putting these implants in people's heads, making them cyborgs and all these different weird-ass things, man. You know, immortality was only promised to the Israelites. It wasn't promised to you heathens, especially you damn Edomites, you know. It's only given to the people that the Lord loves, the Israelites, you know. So this man can think what he want to think, but he ain't gonna get all the Israelites. He gonna get a lot of Israelites, but not all of them. The elect is gonna stand firm, and they gonna make it throughout everything that this devil got planned. You know? So, you know, just wait till our Lord Yahweh Shai comes down and cracks those clouds. Just, hey, this devil gonna be in a world of trouble. You know? The scriptures say, his stuff is flesh, you know, but the Lord is spirit. I'm paraphrasing certain scriptures, you know. When the Lord cracked those clouds and, you know, this man was fighting in his war and they turn around to fight against our Lord, they ain't gonna be able to do nothing. It's gonna be easy work, you know? But hey, I just wanted to do another video on this, man. The MOTB is coming soon. You know, Jacob's Trouble is coming soon. So, hey, you know, Lord willing, this video is edifying. I'm going to close out, man. You know, keep pushing. Keep prophesying. Hey, fast if you need to. Keep praying. Pray more than ever. You know, we at the end, man. So, until next time, I want to say shalom. Wadababa, shalom.